Hey everyone, One Big Boss here, and as you can tell from the title of the video that you clicked on, we are talking, well, the Power Rangers fan film that has caused a lot of controversy, and quite frankly, I don't understand why it's caused so much controversy. I mean, the thing was fucking great. The movie, if you haven't seen this fan film, it's like off on YouTube and all the other places. It's still available on the director's Facebook page, but you can probably find it on YouTube now because everybody keeps uploading this. Now, this fan film, within the span of 24 hours, hit over 1 million views. 1 million fucking views! Like, how insane is that? That, and it wasn't a shit production either. This was good. This was good Hollywood effects. But the reason why it was better than Hollywood was because the right people were behind making it. So, I was blown away when I saw it. It was violent, dark, gritty. The fighting and the choreograph and the stories for individual characters were unreal. And certain veteran Rangers who, you know, the characters were based, of the actors that played them before, years ago, back in, 20 years ago, they liked it. Some of them liked the characters and, how they had more growth in them. And let's face it, there was a lot more growth with these characters than there were in the original cartoon, in the original TV series. Because, let's face it, if you weren't the Red Ranger or the mysterious Sixth Ranger and everything, you were pretty much a nobody the whole damn time in Power Rangers. In the original Power Rangers, not so much. Like, Billy, as the Blue Ranger, as time went on, he got a lot and everything, but quite frankly, not a lot of other people got a lot of growth. And that's what I liked about this. There was growth. There was real characteristics to these characters. It was a dark, fall from grace kind of thing. And James Vanderbeek, holy shit, who would have ever thought he could act like that? I mean, maybe he's done movies before where he had to be dark and violent, but I'm not too sure because I don't really follow his work. I just know him from Dawson's Creek, like the rest of the world. But you know, because he's a comedy actor in many ways. But he was unreal. And even what's his name? Steve Cardenas, who played Rocky, he praised Vanderbeek's way, his style in that. It was really good. It just bothers me. And most people are like, well, you know, like, how can they get away? Like, why can't they get away with it? The guys from Bat and the Sun did it. And I was like, look, the reason why Bat and the Sun was actually able to get away with doing the Scorpion versus White Ranger was because Saban okayed it, because his poster boy, Jason David Frank, was in it. And let me tell you right now, Jason David Frank, I'm not saying a poster boy as, a negative thing, but he, is the face of Power Rangers because Saban knows he's bankable. Everything, people want to see him and stuff, so he's bankable, so he okays this stuff. So, you know, I love that White Ranger versus Scorpion thing, by the way. That thing was fucking unreal. But that was very violent, okay? Like, PG-13 violence to me is, minor swearing, minor violence, you know. But getting the Saba sword under your head and sticking it out through your skull, all bloody and shit like that, that's kind of rated R. And Jason David Frank did say he's a PG-13 kind of guy. But that was pretty dark. Okay? And then the alternate version of that was the White Ranger getting Scorpion's, his grappling hooks thing, his stinger or whatever, right through his fucking head. And it was like, okay, so that's clearly rated R. But this comes out, and because there's coke and drugs and violence and a lot of death, that's not okay? Quite frankly, it's on the same level, really. It really is. And, you know, like I said, you don't see Marvel or DC doing this, because the guys who produced and directed this and everything like that, they'd done other stuff, and there's a Batman versus Predator and the Punisher Dirty Laundry, which, for the love of God, if you have not seen the Punisher Dirty Laundry, go watch it. But you don't see them doing it. They appreciate when fans do this shit. But Saban is like, oh no, I don't like that and everything like that. You know, but what the fuck? You know, I seen people bitching about it and supporting that this thing should never have come to light and it ruins the franchise. And I'm like, how? How the fuck does it ruin a franchise that, quite frankly, during the Disney era, ruined itself? Okay? I mean, I gotta admit, Dino Charge is really amazing. I think it's way better than Super Mega Force and anything they've done in years, pretty much since Dino Thunder. But holy shit, you guys gotta be kidding me with some of the shit that I've read that you say. You really are a bunch of whining fucking pussies is what you are. Because This was not made for your children to watch. This was not made to be kid-friendly in any way. This was for fans like me. At 27 years old, there's other ones that used to watch the show, so they're like in their 30s now and everything. And this is what we've wanted. Everybody's wanted that dark, gritty Power Rangers fan. Even the older Power Rangers have said they've heard it from people. We want the darker, we want grittier. And that's what this was. And you're all out there bitching that it ruined the franchise and it's going to harm the children and there's kids out there and everything. It's like, you can't shield kids from bad shit. I'm sorry, you just can't do it. But you can control what they watch on the internet, because shit like that, you can stop them from watching. Now, if a 14 or 15, 16, 17-year-old watches it, that's no big deal. But if you're worried about like a 5 to 10-year-old watching it on YouTube, why the fuck are you giving them access to a computer like that without proper guidance? Or you there watching what they're doing? You know? Like, I've seen so many people on these Facebook sites that look like people that never moved out of their mother's basements and shit like that, supporting Saban and saying, yeah, that was right that you shut this down. This was something that is an atrocity. It is bad for the franchise. And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, seriously. Power Rangers is something that has touched a lot of people's lives. It got people into martial arts. It gave people confidence. You know, there was great merchandising for it. Saban made an ass load of money. And fans, as I always said, when it comes to anything that's been made and fans want to do a film or a game or something, fans do it right. Hollywood fucks it up. And these guys went to... They obviously had money to do this, and they put it into it. Script writing, acting, the twists, the action, giving other characters time to grow. That was awesome. But unfortunately, not a lot of people saw it that way. And you know what? Like, I'm not saying that like you can't have your opinion if you don't like it. That's fine. But don't be attacking other people that say like that they liked it because it's what they wanted. If it's not what you wanted, fine. But when you're being blatant assholes and douchebags about, like, you know, just saying, like, well, I didn't personally like it, but if you like it, that's fine. I can understand why some people just liked it, but it's not for me. It's not what I grew up on. And again, those kind of, like, talking like that, that's okay. That's okay to talk like that, because that's being a human being, which on the internet, everybody's just a fucking keyboard warrior and says whatever the fuck they want. But, you know, I don't think what Saban's doing is a good idea. But, hey, what do? I'm a dude wearing sunglasses, doing YouTube videos and you know, doing Let's Plays and shit like that. I don't have multi-million dollars in a franchise that I've milked and shit like that. But, regardless, I think that when big companies end up doing this shit, it really hurts them. Because fans are fans are how you get your fucking money, is the thing. If you got fans that, you know, do artwork, or they get people into something, you know, they get them into the franchise, then, you know, like, that helps. Being a fan is what you need to make your series survive. I mean, for granted, like, there's cartoons, like, best example, He-Man. Everybody is obsessed with, like, He-Man and the Transformers and stuff, and at conventions, you see great Transformer cosplays, you see great Skeletor cosplays, He-Man, all this weird, hilarious shit. And it helps boost your sales. And it helps make your series relevant to a newer age. Because He-Man was like 25, 30 years ago almost. And same with the Transformers almost. Like, that was almost 30 years now. So, Saban, like, seriously, you done fucked up by pissing off a lot of your fan base, okay? Because you know it. You know that you got fans of this series everywhere. And the fact that the actors that used to work for you, that, you know, quite frankly, you did fuck over, love this. They thought it was great. Jason David Frank, not so much. He said his inner geek was like, yay, but he was like, you know, he's like, I keep it strictly PG-13 related and stuff. And, you know, if that's his bag, fine. That's what he does. But I'm sorry. It's not PG-13 when you shove a sword through a guy's head or you get a fucking, like, kunai, like, right through your head, too. Like, that's not PG-13, my friend. But regardless, what are your thoughts on this? Do you think Saban should stop being a fucking baby and just allow this guy to spread the word for the fans who wanted to always see a darker one? Or do you agree that he should be shutting this down even though nobody's making money off this? Either way, let me know in the comments down below, because this is something that, you know, a lot of people are upset about. And the fact that this got like over a million views in 24 hours, and I think it almost hit 8 million at one point, that tells you something, that this thing was damn good. 8 million people, almost, if I'm right about that. I'm pretty sure it was before it got taken down. liked what they saw and are probably going to go out and buy, like, maybe, like, they never thought, oh, you know, I don't really need those legacy things now. But after seeing that fan film, it's like, I want to get that legacy morpher. I have got to get it, you know? So, either way, thanks, everybody, for watching. You know, thumbs up the video, like and subscribe, all that good stuff, because it's free. And this day and age, free is a damn good thing. As always, everybody, thank you for watching. I'm One Big Boss, and I will see you all next time.